Good morning. My name is Sheila Gautreaux. I'm one of your ministers here at Unity of Walnut Creek, and it is my pleasure to welcome you to our 11:30 service. This morning, we're going to be talking about tithing, but we're going to be talking about it from several approaches, but the primary one is that it is an act of love. And so I hope that you will get something from this that you can use in your life. Our music today is Sonny Fairley and our fabulous band, Fusion. Our song leaders are Diana Harris and Dorothy Edwards. So sit back, relax, prop up your feet, and get ready for a wonderful experience. And thank you so much for being with you, us. We love it when you're here.
Welcome. Please join us as we sing, I Am Free.
I am free. I am unlimited. There are no chains to bind me. I am free. I am unlimited. Right now, right now. I am free. I am unlimited. There are no chains that bind me. I am free. I am unlimited. Right now, right now. You are free. You are unlimited. There are no chains to bind you. You are free. You are unlimited. Right now, right now. You are free. You are unlimited. There are no chains to bind you. You are free. You are unlimited. Right now, right now. We are free. We are unlimited. There are no chains to bind us. We are free. We are unlimited. Right now, right now. We are free. We are unlimited. There are no chains. Bind us, we are free, we are unlimited, right now, right now.
All right. Thanks to Dot and Diana for leading us in song, and we have back as our one of those favorite guest musicians, the magnificent Sonny Fairley. Thank you, Sonny, for being here. Yeah. And Fusion, you make it so good all the time. Thank you, guys. My name is David MacArthur, and I get to play here as one of your ministers. And it is such a delight to be able to welcome everybody to this service, to this experience of our beautiful Unity community. And for everyone online, welcome. It's great to have you here. Let's wave to them and let them know that we're glad. Hey, folks. If you're new to Unity, welcome. Just wiggle around, get comfortable, make yourself, and welcome home. The beautiful work that happens here is part of the unfolding of what we call a positive path for spiritual living. And in that experience, we get to touch on some of the great universal truths that are a part of the spiritual growth of all beings. And so in our services today, you may hear music, you may hear scriptures that are part of different traditions as we celebrate that universal connection we have with the unfolding and awakening of humanity. The first part of our service we spend focused in prayer and meditation. And we begin that entry into the experience of prayer by sharing together our opening statement, our opening affirmation, where we acknowledge and awaken within ourselves the awareness of this divine presence in which we live and move and have our being. So I invite you to join me together. There is only one presence and one power in the universe and in my life, the all-loving goodness of God. Taking that gentle breath through the heart. And again, there is only one presence and one power in the universe and in my life, the all-loving goodness of God. Feeling that love once again. There is only one presence and one power in the universe and in my life, the all-loving goodness of God. Aware of this infinite love, we are so grateful. Amen. Please join us in our next song.
Bye.
Well, good morning. This is such a special time, a time of prayer and meditation. And so I invite you to join me now, and like Reverend David usually says, wiggle around and find that comfortable spot and prepare. Let us prepare by taking in this music, that it may deepen our experience of this time of reflection. Join us if you're willing. If you have not already done so and you're willing, join me in closing our eyes to shut out any visual distractions that we may see truly. And take some deep heart breaths, slow, deep heart breaths. And continuing to breathe normally through our hearts, in and out. Let us bring ourselves more deeply into that inner sacred sanctuary. That place where we meet and greet, connect with, and know the Lord of our being. And as we allow ourselves to settle more deeply into this sacred space, we begin a precious communion with the Beloved. Here in this place, we can set aside our challenges, our difficulties, and other life circumstances, and rest and relax in the comfort that all is well. That we are made in the image and likeness of the Creator of the universe. And we are whole and perfect as we were created before the world was. And drawing closer now to this sacred love, we release all fear, all doubt, all criticism, condemnation, and judgment of ourselves or others. knowing that we are divinely perfect. That we were made in love. And drawing closer, we allow ourselves to feel that resplendent intelligence of the heart. Aligning with the truth of our being. And as we prepare to go into that silent space, let us hold love, the feeling of love, the divine idea of love, the experience of love, as we rest in the silence. Arising from this place of rest, ascending into the highest possibilities of our conscious connection to the divine. We allow this love to bring us back into our lives. Beloved presence, mother and father of us all, we are grateful for this time we have spent with you and each other. We are grateful for the love that extends from us, through us, by us, and as us, flowing into our families, our communities, our nation, over the rivers and mountains to our world, and the hills and valleys touching every heart that beats. And as we move further into the everyday life, we allow that love to continually flow, walking and living in the light of love and allowing divine love to flow through our hearts enfolding and blessing the world. We know that divine love flows through my heart, enfolding and blessing the world. Please join me. Divine love flows through my heart, enfolding and blessing the world. Breathe it in, breathe it in. And again, divine love flows through my heart, enfolding and blessing the world. And let's send it out there once more. Divine love flows through my heart, enfolding and blessing the world. For it could not be otherwise. And together we say, Amen.
Thank you, Sonny. So glad you got CDs for us out on the patio. Yeah. All right. Good morning. My name is Veronica Wolf, and it is truly my pleasure to highlight some of our upcoming events here at Unity Walnut Creek. So calling all Unity members today, we will have a very, very brief membership meeting after this service to vote on the restatement of our Articles of Incorporation. So please stay with us for a few minutes after service. Next Sunday afternoon, join Garrett Reig for Forgiveness and Joy, A Course in Miracles workshop. This will be an overview of A Course in Miracles and the revolutionary view of forgiveness. So uplift your heart, transform your thinking, and improve your relationships. Now, you've probably heard about this thing called radical forgiveness. A little bit, okay. If you've been wondering what all the fuss is about on the fourth Sunday, please come join our own Sheila Gautreaux for a one-hour introduction. I highly recommend it. And the details of these events and others are in your bulletin and on our website. And now's the fun here. You get to greet and hug each other until you hear that gong.
Please stay standing and join us in singing The Power of God.
The power of God is within me. I know. The power of God is within me. I know. The power of God is within me. I know. The power of God is within me. Yes, I know. Oh, yes, I know. The power of God is within me. I know. The love of God is within me. I know. The love of God is within me. I know. The love of God is within me. Yes, I know. Oh, yes, I know. The light of God is within me. I know. The light of God is within me. Light of God is within me. I know. The light of God is within me. Yes, I know. Oh, yes, I know. The peace of God is within me. I know. The peace of God is within me. I know. The peace of God is within me. I know.
Thank you, Sonny. Oh, isn't it great to have jazz on a Sunday morning? Yeah, yeah. Those of you who didn't know, the song that Sonny played after the meditation, it's God Has Smiled on Me, and it is so beautiful. So maybe one of these times we'll sing it here. But it's a gorgeous song, absolutely gorgeous song. And so I was so glad that I didn't have to get up to speak after the playing of that song. So this morning, I'm going to be having a straight no-chaser conversation. I'm going to be talking to you about, ready? Tithing. It's a subject I really love. I really do. And it's very powerful, especially when you really understand what it is. Recently, what brought me to wanting to do this was I was on a conversation with one of my best friends, and she was administrator for a religious science-based church in Sacramento. And she was telling me they were having some challenges, and a lot of their congregants were having a lot of challenges. And they had been brainstorming about, you know, what it could be, so forth and so on. And one Sunday when she was platform person, she was blessing the tithes and offerings, and she said, we want to bless our auto tithers and so forth and so on. So after service, this young man came up to her, and, you know, he was in his 30s, so he was young, according, as far as I'm concerned. So came up to her and said, what's an auto tither? He was thinking it was people who tithe from their cars. So she explained to him that it was people who had their love offerings, their tithes, taken directly out of their credit card or their bank account. He said, oh, well, what's a tithe? So she explained to him what a tithe was. And after he walked away, she said, that's probably the challenge here in our ministry, because we have failed to teach our congregation the divine law of compensation, of giving and receiving. So we have failed them in a tremendous way because we have kept them from having the rewards of that relationship with the universe between giving and receiving. And so that was our conversation. I said, well, we've got a lot of new people coming into our ministry. How many of you have noticed that we've got a lot of new people, younger people, right? You know, 30s and so forth. Yeah, that's young, by the way. And it is all relative. And I realized, well, I think that we have done them a disservice about sharing with them the concept of giving and receiving. So I asked David, I said, David, can I do a tithing talk? So he said, sure. And he gave me a date to do it, and here I am. So what I want to get to today, and the topic, the title of my talk is Tithing is a Four-Letter Word, Love. And that's what I want to get across today, is that it's an act of love. And the scripture I use is from 2 Corinthians, and it's the closing, almost the closing, in a letter by Paul to the church at Corinth. And during that part of the Bible, you'll see a lot of letters. Paul's letter to the Philippians and so forth, the Thessalonians and so forth. He wrote letters to all of the newly formed churches that he and Peter and other disciples were setting up and organizing throughout the world as it was spreading, as the teachings of Jesus were spreading. And they were creating places where people could come to learn about these profound teachings and to apply them to their lives so that they could reap the benefits of what Jesus had taught when he was with us. So they wrote when he couldn't travel, because the travel was quite cumbersome during those times, and not all of the churches were on one continent. So it could be 2 to 3 months travel by boat for him to go and visit. So when he couldn't visit, he would write letters. And normally he would talk about giving an offering at the end of some of his letters. And this scripture is about just that thing. And it says, let each one give as he declares, not by compulsion, but in joy. And he's talking about not by obligation, not by compulsion, not by regret or hesitation or an unwillingness, but in joy. And some translations say, but in love, or from the heart. And what he's talking about is giving a new understanding to tithing, to giving. If you go back to the Old Testament, tithing got started with the Hebrews giving 23% of their good to support the Levites. And the Levites, I like to refer to them as sub-priests or associate ministers. And then the Levites would give 10% to the priest or minister, senior minister. And because the senior minister and the associate ministers did not have a job, the Jewish community supported them with their tithes and their offerings. Now, in the Jewish community, tithing was a requirement. It was not a free will offering as it became in the New Testament, after the New Covenant, after Jesus's new teachings around the old Jewish laws. But before that, it was a requirement. And even in this day, from what I understand, it is still a requirement in the synagogue to remain a member in good standing. You are required to tithe 10% of your earnings to support the synagogue, the continuation of the synagogue. But what he is saying here is that he's practically implying, and if you go, you know, further in the scripture, that he'd rather not have it if it's given with reluctance or by compulsion. Reluctance, compulsion. Compulsion is because I have to, because you said I have to. And reluctance is, I really don't feel like giving this 10%, back then it was 23%, of my income. I keep thinking about what I could do with it. He says, I'd rather not have it, but let them give in joy. What he's referring to is the joy within the heart as you lovingly give to that ministry, or lovingly give, period, in your life. When there is joy and love in the heart, it initiates that energetic cycle of giving and receiving. When it's given reluctantly or because you're forced to, that energy of connection that comes from the heart out into the universe to inspire that energy of the universe to return to us in like kind and even greater, it does not happen. So he is actually teaching that by giving from this place of love, we are also returning the good to ourselves. Now, day before yesterday, my friend Dot and I were out. She had driven me to a memorial service that I had to do, and we were going to the post office, and she had picked out a birthday card for her grandson, Langston. And she was so excited. There was so much love and joy in her face. I mean, she was like a little kid herself. And she was telling me all about the card. It was sealed, and she also had an envelope with a nice little healthy check in it. Langston likes money. And so she said, and the card was huge. She said, there's a dragon on it, and when you open it, it roars. And all that love and excitement and telling me how much Langston loved money and so forth was just vibrating, and I could see it and feel it. So I imagined how it would feel to Langston when he opened it up, not just because of the roar, but because the love and excitement and joy that went into choosing it and that went into sending it to Langston. Are you with me? Yeah. And so think about it. Have you ever purchased a gift for someone you truly love? A beloved, a grandchild, a dear friend? I know you've purchased for your grandchildren. And you were excited, and you were excited about picking up that perfect gift. Do you know what I mean? And when you found it, do you remember how you felt? Do you remember the love and the joy? And you actually probably were imagining how they would feel when they opened it, right? So it's kind of like that when we give or when we tithe to where we receive our good. So let's kind of look at where this whole tithing thing, as I said, I told you where it comes from, but what is it? Tithing, we'll use the old term and then we'll move into the new one, is an act of lovingly giving a portion of your good, and the standard is 10%, of your good to support the place in which you receive your spiritual instruction, support, and enlightenment. Now, how many of you, when you first walked into a Unity Church or this Unity Church, felt like you had come home? And how many of you have reaped powerful benefits within your own life from the things that you have learned and discovered within this ministry? It makes a powerful difference. So when you think of all that you've received from the place where you receive your spiritual good, and you're in the process of giving to support that ministry, it is essential that you remember the wonders of what you've received and the joy that you feel when you come here in the act of giving. Now, tithing is supposed to be, according to spiritual law and metaphysical concepts, 10%. Now, I like to say that tithing is so powerful that if you can't start with 10%, start with a smaller amount until you are able to graduate to that 10%. Why 10%? Well, the number 10 represents perfection, perfect balance, the masculine and feminine together, resplendent love, doesn't that sound like heart math? The heart, resplendent love. It also is said to be the divine number, and it reduces to one, which is oneness. So when we are giving that 10%, we are aligning ourselves with the universe, with the oneness of the universe. We are connected. We are
realizing that there is no difference between us and God. And that as we put out that 10%, we have already initiated the act of receiving. And it may not show up in money, it might show up in services. It may show up in gifts from others. It may show up in a blessing somehow, but you will know that it is your good returning to you. My friend Mike McGarvey, when he took his first 4T class, said when they ask, you know, they ask at the beginning, what is it you want to manifest? And he said, oh, $1 million. So down the line, several months later, he's at Unity Village for a weekend retreat. And at the end of it, he said, wow, that was worth $6 million. So it may come in a $6 million experience. It may be the development of a $6 million relationship. It may be the discovery of a job that you feel like a millionaire because of what you experience when you're there doing that job. So it may not come in exactly the form it went out, but it does come. Now, I personally was in a position at one time where my finances were really low and I had just lost half of the income in my life and still had a lot of the outgo. So I was looking at paying bills and so forth, and suddenly I said, I really can't afford to tithe. So I stopped. I started losing money. I mean, just would lose money. Large sums, just couldn't find it. My engagements, speaking and workshops, started drying up. I started losing other things. And then I fell and broke my wrist. And I'm saying, what is going on? What is happening? And I said, oh, I stopped tithing. I quickly got a check and wrote out a tithe check and began tithing again. And didn't take long. Within a month, 6 weeks, I began to see the fruits of my giving, because I would tithe with love. But in that one moment, fear hit me and I began to lose faith in what I had known worked all the time. And so I created an opportunity for me to discover that my tithing, my giving with love, putting it out into the universe, putting it out to support the ministry, was opening the way, opening the portal for all good to come my way. I want to read something for you from someone's book. She says, I threw myself across my daughter's bed one day, and I cried, and I cried, and I cried, and I cried. I had not been able to break through, to create a breakthrough in our expenses, no matter how hard I tried. So I cried. And when I was finished crying, I sat up, and in a loud, strong voice, I declared, God, from this day forth, I will give even if I get nothing in return. Within weeks, I began to break through the challenges of our finances, and prosperity began to flow. And to this very day, prosperity flows abundantly in my life. Joyce Meyer. That's the other piece. Whether we get anything back or not. So we don't give from a place of getting. We give from a place of giving. we lovingly offer out our tithes, our love offerings. And we do receive. Yes, it is great to expect a miracle, to expect, but to give only because of what you will get is not in alignment with that circular energy of the law of compensation, of the law of giving and receiving. So tithing has various aspects to it. There is the tithing of your money, but there is also the tithing of your time. What is it that you do that you can tithe to the ministry that you love? What kind of things are you good at? Maybe bookstore once a week, a couple hours? There must be something that you are good at, that you can lovingly offer as a tithe to your ministry. Tithing is tithing your talents. Can you sing? Come join my choir. Can sing but don't have time for regular rehearsals? Become a song leader. What talents do you have? Marketing? We definitely can use it. What skills could you contribute? What talents could you contribute to support the ministry that feeds you? And it doesn't have to be this ministry, but if there's another ministry that feeds you, no problem. But what I'm saying is give somewhere, somehow, to someone. And I'm also not talking about just in terms of giving money. What are you giving into your family? Are you giving in love to your family? Are you giving in love to your community? Are you giving in love to your job? Are you doing your job with absolute love? Because that's giving. That's giving. So our goal is to give in love across the board, in every aspect of our lives. Are we giving in love to our world, regardless of what is going on, what we are seeing before us? Are we giving love? We are seeking to live a life of giving love. So I have some steps for you as far as tithing. And then the first step, know and develop a relationship with your source. And we do this through prayer and meditation. We get into alignment and we feel our connection to the one source. We feel that energy of connection and we're developing the energy that takes us through to the next step. The next is trust. Trust in that all-providing nature of our source. The next is faith. Have faith that you are being provided for even before you ask. God knows the desires of your heart. We ask as a sealing of the relationship between us. And so we speak the word to set the energy in motion. The heart. Go into the heart and experience the joy and love from the heart, so that you can have an understanding of how it feels to give in love. give. Give lovingly from the place of the heart and in alignment with what the heart has declared is the amount for you to give. Align with that. And the last, well, I know what that one is, receive. We open our minds and our hearts in a receptive way to receive the good from God, pressed down, shaken together, running over, back in good measure. We receive. There's a song that I learned years ago, a minister wrote in Kansas City, and give and it's given back to you. Give and it's given back to you. Give and it's given back to you. Pressed down, shaken together, running over, back in good measure. God gives it back to you. So come sing it with me. Ready? Given, it's given back to you. Given, it's given back to you. Given, it's given back to you. Pressed down, shaken together, running over, back in good measure. God gives it back to you. Ready? Give and it's given back to you. Give and it's given back to you. Give and it's given back to you. Pressed down, shaken together, running over, back in good measure. God gives it back to you. Okay, let's do the hand movements. Ready? Ready? Give and it's given back to you. Give and it's given back to you. Give and it's given back to you. Pressed down, shaken together, running over, back in good measure. God gives it back to you. One last time. Ready? Give and it's given back to you. Give and it's given back to you. Give and it's given back to you. Press down. Get the hips going. Shaken together, running over. Back in good measure. God gives it back to you. So I want you all to sing that song. What I really want is for you to, through the week, look at every place to see if you are giving in love. At home, at work, driving in traffic, instead of the one finger wave, give love. Everywhere you go, the grocery store, wherever you go, give in love. So I want to challenge you this week to be aware of how you are giving, how you are speaking about our world and what's going on is giving. So I want you to think about it, because we have a tendency to do the criticism, condemnation, and judgment, do we not? Okay, tell the truth. This week, when you hear it, even if it makes you go to the heart. Find a way to give love. Find that, even if it's a little bit, find a way to give love, because love changes everything. And as you give love, what happens? You receive love. So let's do this affirmation that I wrote for us. Okay, ready? I give from love, and love itself out upon me abundantly. Again, I give from love, and love itself out upon me abundantly. And once more, boldly and bravely, I give from love, and love pours itself out upon me abundantly. Abundantly. So, I give you love. I give you peace. I give you joy. And may you find this every moment of every day in your life and in your relationships. Thank you.
That's a great message, Sheila, and you are such a role model for us, for tithing, for giving your time, your talents. I've seen it, we know it, thank you. Thank you so much. Our heart ministers are available after service today to offer prayer support for challenges and celebrations. You may see them around the sanctuary or on the grounds praying with others. They're wearing lavender stoles, so you can identify them easily. Prayer requests can also be sent anytime online and through our website. So now I'm going to ask everyone in sanctuary to take out one of those connection cards from the seat pocket in front of you. And we invite you to take a moment and fill out the card, especially if you have a prayer request or a question or a comment. We know that the power of prayer works. If you are new to Unity, you're invited to fill out the card and stop by the welcome table out on the patio. And we look forward to meeting you. So our spiritual focus this week is give from the heart. Give from the heart. And the ushers will receive your card and the offering toward the end of the music. And so now it is time to go into action. Prosperity celebration. For credit card donations, there are envelopes provided on the back of the chairs in front of you. Or for those of you at home, just click on the donate button on the Watch Live page. So here's our lesson this week. Unity's co-founder, Charles Fillmore, taught that our spiritual connection opens us to God's abundance expressing in our lives. And he said, quote, "Poverty or prosperity, it all depends on you. All that the Father has is yours, but you alone are responsible for the relationship of the Father's good in your life. Through conscious recognition of your oneness with the Father and his abundance, you draw the living substance into visible supply." So keep that relationship good. So let's take our tithes and our love offerings in our hands and be aware that God is the source of all your good. And let's repeat this affirmation together. Divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive, and I'm grateful.
Pieces of information I thought you might want to know. Okay, at the end of our service, we have our meeting. And I wanted to just let you know what we're going to do is after the have fun, we're just going to sit back down. Should be very quick. Anyone that needs to bolt for the door, go for it. But we'll just sit right back down, do our meeting real quickly, and then everybody can take off and have a great afternoon. Ready? Thank you. Right, embrace those beautiful beings with your hearts, and let's share our affirmation together. Children, you are loved, special, and important. The light of God shines through you. All right, so let's take hands and share together our prayer protection. Together, the light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us, and the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. And our peace song. Light and the peace in the earth right now. So let it shine and have fun. All right, and sit back down and get comfortable. everyone. Invite you to sit down. We'll do this really quickly, and we will have a brand new amended, altered, and otherwise acceptable Articles of Incorporation. So let me introduce Chris Gomes, who is the Vice President of our board. Chris?
Thank you, David. Good afternoon, everybody. First of all, I have a quick brief message from Sappho. She's in Southern California celebrating a decade birthday that her family threw for her, so she had to go. We have one item on our agenda this afternoon, and that is to for you all to vote and accept the restated Articles of Incorporation for our community. They were last amended in the early 1980s when we submitted them for the property tax exemption for the 2880 Buena Vista property. They sent it back to us and very kindly said, incomplete, maybe you want to look at your articles and resubmit, which was very nice instead of just saying, no, go away. So with Garrett Reed's very capable work, we have, and he's brought it to the board twice and we've worked on it. It's now very succinct, simple. It has been published on the website. I hope everybody's had a chance to take a look at it. And if there are no questions, we can just go right to a motion to accept.
I make a motion to accept.
I second it.
Thank you, Rick, and thank you, Sandy. Okay. All members present voting yes, please stand. We're good. Please be seated. I see everybody standing, so I think we're finished, and that adjourns our meeting. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Have a great afternoon.